Singapore has a food problem. And no, we're not talking about not being able to decide what to eat for lunch. Singapore imports 90% of our food, and that's an obvious problem. If we continue to hurtle towards ecological collapse, we could foresee ourselves eating like a Victorian child, having more food shortages and even more pandemics. Not to jinx anything, but what if there's a COVID-24? I don't know about you, but I'm not ready for another round of getting cut off from the rest of the world. Nothing has made our dependence on the globalized world as obvious as the pandemic. Our food is more well-traveled than the average Singaporean who hasn't seen the world outside of Johor, Bali or Bangkok. But Singapore's the king of buzzwords, and so we have the Green Plan, we have the East Coast Plan, and we have a 30 by 30 plan. So no, this is not the Forbes 30 under 30, but this is Singapore sustainably growing 30% of our nutritional food by 2030. So in case if anything happens, we can get by while we find new sources of food. We won't be self-sustaining, but it's better than nothing. With only 1% of our land reserved for farming, the 30% goal is an uphill climb, which means that our farmers will have to get creative. Luckily for us, the production of chicken eggs in Singapore is already meeting the 30% goal, but there is still a long way to go for all the other food groups. So how are we working towards the 30 by 30 goal? The answer lies in Lim Chu Kang and Kranji, and so our countryside is about to become less rural. Existing plots like this will be reorganized and optimized, while infrastructure investment in shared facilities will also help to triple our current food production capacity. Over here in Kranji, the soon-to-be-built Agri-food Innovation Park at Sungai Kadut will bring together high-tech farming and research and development activities, including indoor plant factories, insect farms, and animal feed production. And if you find this place familiar, well, this used to be the rail corridor. If horizontal land is an issue, then no problem, we will go upwards! The tech's not new. We've been growing plants like this for a while now. And aeroponic systems like this can use less space, less manual labor, and also 95% less water. Urban farms can be situated in underutilized spaces, just like on rooftops and in car parks. In fact, you can probably use the same methods to grow food at home. Learn from them obsessive plant daddies. But instead of growing your fancy, useless plants, grow something edible for a change. Not to be pessimistic, but even if we meet that goal, that's only 30% of our food supply. If the apocalypse happens earlier than that, we can say goodbye to all our imported food. Say goodbye to steak, to lamb, to turkey, and say hello to the food that we can grow here. A huge part of agricultural land worldwide is used to grow food for livestock. And in Singapore, that's just not possible. So we have to look for alternative sources of protein that we can grow here. I'm not talking about plant-based or lab-grown meat. There's no electricity during an apocalypse, what? How to grow meat in a petri dish? I'm talking about insects. Disgusted? Don't be. Insects have been a part of Southeast Asian culture since forever. From sago worms, to crickets, to grasshoppers, we've been eating insects for ages. And don't think that eating insects are just desperate measures for desperate times. Crickets are the best source of protein. One serving of crickets has twice the amount of protein than one serving of chicken breast. So whether you're a gym rat or just a regular rat, crickets might soon become part of your diet. But sure, it'll take some time before society gets over the itchy-squitchy appearance of insects. In the meantime, insect protein could probably start appearing in food in the form of flour. All the goodness of the insects with none of the creepiness.
While our local farms continue to work hard towards a more sustainable food future, supporting local is easier than ever. Local produce is not a gimmick. They're already available all over Singapore in supermarkets. Just look out for this sticker. It might not be that much more expensive, and it's as fresh as it can get, straight from the farm to your table in a matter of days.
A food resilient future is not a luxury, but a necessity, and it is not impossible. It might take some creative thinking, changing palates, and a bigger appetite for alternative sources of food, but ultimately, as the world gears itself up for a greener future, we must recognize that the most sustainable, most environmentally friendly food is what we can grow in our backyard.